I have one last unboxing to do from this Ketchup CD package. And this is actually an album. I changed my original album in this package because my original album in this package was Stellar's white version of Stellar Into the World, but Ketchup City didn't have a white version, so only the black version. So, and they messaged me because I had it in my message, blah blah blah, and then I asked them to change it to this album, which is a bit cheaper, and I got like a dollar refund. So. It's Topp Dogg's Dogs Out, their first debut mini album, but first and debut is the same. So, I got into Topp Dogg the year after they debuted, like I got it to them with Annie. But actually, Follow Me was basically my favorite title track for quite a long time. So, I actually really need to work on Topp Dogg, and guess what? The Arario special is out of print. So if anyone has the RRDO special not signed, I don't count signed, and it's in fairly good condition, I don't expect it to have all the pages attached because it has poor gluing, but like all the pages, it should have all the pages, one way or another. I really want to buy that album, and also P-Goon's card for that. But let's get started with this. Yeah. Oh, it's not an attached for the book, okay, forgot about that. So, you have all the 13 members here. Yeah, they had the same packaging for a while. I actually quite like that. It's not the best packaging. Probably companies wouldn't do this anymore. But I think it's like a fairly good one. So, yeah, and plastic whatever thingy here, which we don't use anymore. And then it still has Stardom on it. Ew. Not that Hunus is better. Well, a lot has happened to Topp Dogg. Oh, yeah, hopefully it doesn't fall apart because it uses those clip thingies. So yeah, they all had pretty distinct looks in this one, which is actually pretty cool for a debut, especially because they're such a big group. I really wanna have that RRDO special. Oh yeah, and they also did the units way before 17 did it. There will be Hojun and Hanso, they are the wizards, basically the blondies and the popular members in the beginning. Then there is Dragon, which is P-Goon, My Bias, and Sango. And I actually picked... No, I picked him in Ami. And then I was like, what's this hair? And then I got so used to this hair, the sounds it makes. And there's the knight with Kido, Atom, and Nakta. We don't even know if Sangyeon is still a member or not. Kido is not, and that lion. Oh wow! Yano is at least still a member, apparently. Okay, then, let's do this. Tegan, My Bias. Oh, I love him so much. Then there is Sango with the ugly hair, it's like that you shouldn't do ever. And then Kido, it's just like. You don't need to do this when you're a K-pop idol. Then there is Nakta and Atom. Some knights. Some lions with yeah, that Sangun picture. Zenitsu, who is technically my second bias. Then Gon, oh I really like Gon. And Yano. Oh, picture. Then some wizards. There's b-joo and Hojun. It's b-joo, right? And there is Hanso and Jaeho. A group one. Dark group one. Some lyrics. Some more lyrics. I have to repackage cigarettes for this. So now I at least have both of these. So, yeah. Oh, they have fences. That's very cute. Well, what did you do with your face? B-joo definitely doesn't look like this anymore. It's just different. I think some members are going on the unit. Maybe. Something good happens to them. They just... they actually had really interesting concepts. Like their first year was basically like no one else ever did, and they were so ignored, and partly it's because I think Stardom wanted to act like, well, Topp Dogg is doing so well, but in reality they were not, and then it's like, yeah. So I do need to get the other releases, but at least I got this one now, and so I probably, they were surprised at the office. Oh wait, we sold one of that album now? Like, they probably assume it's because of Atom or something on Produce 101, but actually it's not. It's like, I collect Topp Dogg for almost 3 years now. I got their previous two releases when they had to come back, so... Yeah, thank you so much for watching, and... You can't make a happy unboxing of Topp Dogg's, especially old stuff, because, like, so many members left, and you know all the struggles, and... Just, like, how... Yeah, probably I would have had better reactions if I got into them when in the first year and got their album then, but like, I think I wasn't really into boy groups that time anyway, so whatever I did that year. Probably I collected a lot of Tiara after school, and yeah, and Nanuses, yeah, 2013. So thank you so much for watching, and just, I don't know, give Topp Dogg a chance, and even if it you find it strange. Yes, their music is very strange, but it is unique and it has interesting concepts and it's something very different, so I think that's already a reason why it deserves a chance. So yeah, thank you for watching. Bye!